come to God through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Romans chapter 8 verse 34 says Jesus is at the right hand of God interceding for us. 1 John chapter 2 verse 1 says that Jesus is our advocate with the Father. Can I get a witness in here? He's praying for you. He's already praying for you. Now watch this. Notice now, he did not say, Simon, I have prayed that Satan does not sift you. He said, he didn't say, I prayed that he does not attack you.
Right.
He did not say, I prayed that he does not cause trouble in your home. I guess he didn't say, I prayed that he does not shake you.
Yes.
He says, I prayed that in the midst of your trouble. Because he says, in this life, in this world,
come on,
you will have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. He says, Satan's job is to cause you trouble. He says, but I pray that your faith fails not. In other words, he said, I'm praying that you do not totally fail and be absolutely ruined. He says, I'm praying that you do not remain fallen, that you do not stay in sin, that you do not desert me forever. He says, here's what I'm praying. I'm praying that when you go through what you got to go through,
yes.
And even if you fall,
yes.
You don't stay down on the ground. Can I get a witness in here? And even if you walk away from me, you don't stay, you don't walk away forever.
Amen.
Can I get a witness in here?
Amen.
I'm praying that your faith does not utterly fail.
Yes.
Oh my God. My God. Oh my God. That there's this little word in this text that struck me. He said, Satan. He said, Simon, Satan desires to have you. Watch this, that he may sift you as wheat.
Yeah.
But. Oh my God, that changes the whole conversation. It says, Satan may be trying to destroy you, but. You may be tempted to give up and run away, but I have prayed for you. You know why that ought to cause somebody to shout?
Yeah.
You know why somebody ought to just start running?
Yeah.
I know we don't do no running and carrying on, but that ought to cause somebody to get up and just take a lap right around. He said, but
my God,
I have prayed for you. Thank God.
Yeah.
For all he has at you, that is a but. What you want to know that?
Oh, yeah.
wants to destroy your testimony. But the Savior is praying for you. Which makes the last point even more relevant. And that is, Satan's sifting is not final.
Come on.
You witness it there. Oh my God, it's not final. Satan asks for you that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you that your faith does not fail. And when you are converted, King James, and when you are converted, in other words, when you have returned to me, strengthen your brother. In other words, build your brother up. You're going to fail. You're going to go in the wrong direction. It won't jeopardize your sonship, but it can jeopardize your discipleship. And so Jesus wanted Peter to know that, even if he failed, his failure will not be final. Can I get a witness in here? And he says, when you are converted, when you are, when you return to me, when you are, when you have repented and returned to me, he says, strengthen your brother. In other words, he says, tell us and teach us how to tap in to the mercy of God. Help us who have fallen to return. That's why David would say in Psalm 51, restore unto me the joy of salvation and uphold me with your generous spirit. By your generous spirit, watch this. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners will be converted to you. He says, now, here's the thing. I can't teach anybody. I can't strengthen anybody.
Well,
until I have been restored. I can't help you get delivered.
Well,
until I've been delivered.
Make it rain, Bishop.
I can't help you get set free. As long as I am bound. Can I get a witness in here?
Yes, sir.
You
say,
brother, when you are delivered, reach down and strengthen somebody. Can I get a witness in here? Your failure does not have to be final. The good news, you can be restored. 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Today, that even though Satan wants you, even though he wants me to fail, he wants me to fall, and I'm not going to lie, every now and then, I'll be fall, but thank God that you can, you know that we stay out there, you will be to you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Thank you today.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah!
Satan has a goal in mind. He wants to destroy our testimony. He wants to be able to cut you in your heart.
My God.
By shaking the very foundation of the believer. Because he wants us to walk away from you. He wants us to throw in the towel. But thank you for letting us know. We don't have to do that because we're not in this by ourselves. Because whatever Satan has thrown at us, we'll throw at us.
Yes.
We have the power within us.
Yes, sir.
To overcome it.
Yes.
Because you've already prayed for us. Prayed that we don't lose our faith. That we don't utterly fall. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Not only do we thank you for praying for us, we thank you, God, for your resurrection power that's at work in us.